You're joking, right?
Well, yeah. I'm trying to be hopeful. I'm trying to be optimistic about that.
Well, I guess you're too young to be a little pessimistic like me. The fucking things I see out there, people are stupid.
We're on.
I don't hit this again.
No, you can just let it fade away.
I hit the button. This
just
time.
Fade away to oblivion.
That might be a bad thing. I hope it's a good episode, because usually one that hits the record button.
It makes sense for you to hit it because it's on your side of the desk.
I don't need another thing to do.
Another thing to do? What else do you do?
Wow.
I'm talking about within the realm of the podcast. No, Jen, I'm not saying you don't do anything. I'm asking you. Oh, what do you do, John?
What do I do? Yeah. I fund it, number one.
Yeah.
I purchase all the equipment, number two.
Yeah.
I am the more talented and better out of the two of us in acting.
Acting?
What? Not acting. I mean in the face and what people want to hear.
You're the more talented one in the face.
People rather listen to me than you. You could say, Yeah, it's okay.
Wow.
Now, want me to continue?
Yeah.
I spend a lot of time advising you. Come, you got someone in your head.
What do you mean advising me in the realm of the podcast?
And we go live a couple hours a week.
Right.
And I deal with that.
As do I.
Yeah.
I'm the one who holds the phone and.
Why, you're a good phone holder.
And gets the comments for you because you go, what? What does that say? What?
Okay. So I add a lot.
I think you do.
And I
it's
think,
a, it's
and
a,
I think
it's a
you
duo.
Do,
it's
I
a
think
partnership.
You do too. Yes.
Yes.
I just said I want one more thing and you brought it up, so I answered your questions.
You wanted to click it.
I don't do this. Just to be very clear. That's a little gay.
Well, what's,
I just,
why? Just why is that
it.
Gay?
It's
why is that gay?
It's a little gay.
Why?
It looks gay.
Why?
You don't have to explain it. People know it looks gay.
Speaking of looking gay, Colton Underwood, the former Bachelor, came out.
Yep.
Yeah, we all knew it.
Yeah, I don't dislike him. I think it was selfish of him to do what he did.
To go on the show, you mean? Knowing that you're
people
gay?
People looking for love.
He must not have known he was gay.
They're looking for their person. He knew he was fucking. You really? By the way, is this Colton? This is Colton said he'd never been laid, right?
He was a virgin, yeah.
Okay, but I guarantee he had gay experience beforehand.
I doubt it. I think
look it up.
Look up. How would
let's
I know
call,
that?
Let's call Colton.
Yeah, how would I know
can
that?
Can you DM him? Slide into his DM.
He does now have
a boyfriend?
No, they're filming a TV show that's going to be like on E! Network or something, or
like
Bravo.
Colton gone gay?
About like Colton in the gay world. Like,
I don't know. I won't watch it.
But I mean, that was
he
announced
was
the day.
He was vanilla anyway.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I'm not wasting my time.
But then also why, like in his season, he was so obsessed
was
with the girl. Cassie, he was obsessed with her
maybe,
to the point where she had to get a restraining order on him.
Maybe he's bisexual.
He came out as gay, not as bi.
Because I guess he was a little bitch and he couldn't get a girl, and therefore because
maybe he
be
just
gay.
Thought that that's what he needed to do.
Who the fuck knows? But I guarantee he had his dick sucked by somebody and put in for her. I do. I believe that. I think.
I doubt. I think he was just so like immature sexually that he just didn't even know.
Really, 20-something-year-old?
Yes.
No, I guarantee. Guarantee he had his dick sucked by a guy prior to meeting what's her name?
Cassie,
who was really cute.
Yeah, but also like vanilla as well.
Okay, really? I don't think so.
What? Tell me something about her personality besides how she looks.
I don't know any of their personality.
Right, so vanilla.
No, okay.
Oh, you were talking about vanilla in terms of Colton's looks or in terms of who he is as a person?
No, I mean, I know Colton because he was the main person. He was the Bachelor. So therefore you got to know him. So
but she won. So you get to know.
Yeah,
we know Rachel.
All right.
The one who won this
season. The fact is he knew he was gay beforehand. That's my opinion. My own opinion is he definitely got his dick sucked by a guy or definitely jerked or jerked off by a guy.
Why was he? Maybe he was the giver, not the receiver.
Either way, he had a sexual experience
with a guy.
He was either sucking dick or had his dick sucked.
Wouldn't that be so, I don't even know how that would feel, like, because
okay,
he dated other girls. No, no.
It probably would feel the same as a woman
as a girl. Maybe even better, because guys know what they want. So a guy being down there would know.
Okay, now you're ruining it.
Like, yeah. They say, like, lesbians are way better at going down on a girl than a guy is.
Who's
because
they?
Women.
The same people say don't run with scissors in your hands?
Because women know, like, you know what feels good down there,
okay,
as a guy.
I get it. You know, mom, you know, mom and I were talking and said somehow, I don't know how we got in this conversation, but she thinks, she thinks that all guys have a homosexual tendency.
just guys, so women don't have homosexual tendencies?
She said just guys. Oh, we were at Smoke and Cigar Bar. We're talking about it.
That's. I wonder why she is making it only a guy thing.
Yeah, and I said, just one time doesn't make me gay.
I mean, they do say it's a spectrum.
I think it's a gross conversation, so I really...
The one that brought up...
No, you brought up Colton.
Right,
you
but you're the one that brought up getting his dick sucked.
Because I'm just...
I didn't mention one thing about penises. What I was going to say is I feel
like
it's...
Will it be peni? No, I'm only joking. All right, so...
I feel like it'd be embarrassing. Like, he's dated women publicly, like Tia, the other Bachelor girl who was on Bachelor in Paradise, and they were like... She was like, I'm in love with Colton, whatever. I feel like that's so embarrassing now. Then be like,
well, see, here's my thoughts on Colton.
People watched a relationship.
I think Colton's a nice guy. I think he's obviously got his issues, not because he's gay. That's not what I'm saying. The fact that she had to get a restraining order, I think he has his issues.
Yeah.
I do think the fact that I think it was very selfish of him, I probably use it again. I don't know, but you hear this a lot. They use this whole Bachelor Nation like as a springboard for their social media account. And I think that Colton, my opinion again, had his dick sucked by a guy beforehand, knew he was gay. And I think it's selfish because there's women that really want to find love and there's other bachelors that want to find love. And he was chosen over that other bachelor. So it's okay. But again, Colton,
I honestly feel bad for him. I agree with what you're saying. Like,
I don't dislike
but
him.
But I feel bad for like, that must suck to have to live as 28 years of your life and being like fighting against what you are. That
different,
would suck.
Different issue. I don't dislike him. I just think it was selfish of him. It's not going to change my opinion.
I agree.
He's
it was
a nice
selfish.
Guy.
It was selfish.
I think is. I don't understand, which I would like to talk to him. I don't understand the whole concept. If you really know you're gay, you're battling with the gay and being gay if you don't know you are, but he knows. And then why they're restraining order?
Right, like, because you know you're straight.
Yes.
Like, I know, like, I've always.
You know you're bi, right?
You're talking about me.
Yeah.
I know that I'm straight and I just know. It's just, I know. That's. I correct. Like what I like and I know that. So I feel, but then again, society reinforces that. So if you're into,
you're going deep.
No, but if you're,
that's what she
said. No, because you're saying, you just know, but if you're in society and you're constantly seeing, you should like women. And then you'll be like, oh wait, I don't know. What do I like?
I know, but okay. I don't know. I can't crawl into the mind of a person that is ambivalent like that, but I know when I look and I don't like men. That's all. Like, you know, they're not attractive. Even the most handsome guy, I can admire a guy's fucking body being golden. Like, perfect body. I'm like, that guy's got a sick body. But I don't even know how a woman could be attracted to that body.
No,
balls hanging out, a penis sticking out.
Balls and penises are gross.
All right, I don't want to talk about a guy's body.
I can look at a guy.
And get aroused?
I can say, oh, that's an attractive dude, but I'm not attracted to them, if that makes sense. Yeah, like, I can look at Brad Pitt or, like, Henry Cavill, who plys Superman, and be like, that's a good-looking dude.
That guy's a stud.
I can be like, that's a good-looking dude, but I have no attraction to him.
Superman, I say, that guy's a fucking stud, gets any chick he wants. That's what goes through my mind.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's a stud.
Yeah. He is. Okay.
So I'm at lunch today with Mom, and you saw the pic, and
I got to explain what the picture was.
I'm going to try. I'm going to try. So I'm at lunch.
I'll put it here. It's actually a really funny picture. I'll put it in the video.
I'm out fucking lunch, sitting there, Louis Bossy here in Boca, and we're fucking having a nice time. And next to me, to the right of me, is three fucking women, two who are like a bunch of fucking retards. Both have their dogs.
Why were they retards?
If you see the picture, they're 100.
But you got to explain. There are people who are just listening to this. You have to explain
it. One woman was... Literally, she had her dog, cute dog, like a little Wheaton Terrier dog. But if you have your dog, I get it. I don't mind because I love dogs, obviously. But she has her dog, and the dog's on a leash, but by my feet, by my, like handle your fucking dog. I don't, so I keep giving her a look because I like those, but I'm giving her a look because I'm annoyed at her. Like, handle
it's
your
like
fucking.
If you bring your dog out into the public, watch your dog.
Or you bring your kid screams, take your fucking kid out of it. Right. I don't need to fucking hear your kid scream.
Yeah.
We all have kids. Handle your fucking kid.
And it's like, it's not out of your control. The kid's screaming, but then remove it from the
situation.
Handle
your fucking dog. The dog, so it's the owner. So she's there and you look at her and you're like, of course she's fucking probably divorced three times. And you look at her and like, you want to puke. And so that's one woman, but she wasn't a problem. Then across from her is a dog, is a woman with a stupid fucking hat on. Okay. It's like every chick you would see on fucking Instagram that's single at the same exact fucking post.
She looked like she was older though, no?
So she has her hat on. She has this little fucking white Maltese dog on her lap that she's fucking eating and feeding the dog, and she's on the and of course she'll be singles. Any guy that would ever go with that really fucking I don't care. Not what
I was gonna say. I think it's the opposite. I think she's like that so much with her. I don't think she's single because of that. I think she does that because she's so single. You know what I mean? I think her personality, guys don't want to be around that. So she's like, oh, I need some companion. So she's so into her dog.
Either way, it's a good point. But either way, she's fucking retarded. And so she has
no other show. I honestly love that we say that because nowhere else on the
internet. But I'm not talking about retarded like Down syndrome.
No, I know. And I like that we say that. Because we don't mean it in any offensive way at all.
But it's just a term. It's a term right. I grew up with. There's no. I don't mean it derogatory. I mean it derogatory towards her because she's a moron.
You mean it
like a moron?
Retarded as in the not as in literally like mentally handicapped.
No,
you mean like it a as moron. In retarded as in retarded.
Like you're an idiot moron.
Like when you call if someone's doing something stupid and you say that's so gay. I don't mean it as in homosexual. I mean it as in gay.
Right.
It's just a different word.
So
it's a different word.
So what happens? So she has this dog, and you got to see the so, and the dog has the bow in the hair, the fucking cut with the like little fluffy feet, and a Chanel outfit on the dog, like oh a Chanel God. Fucking outfit on the dog. And I was like, and I go to mom, I go, I can't fuck it. And she goes, I'm trying, it's fucking triggering me, and it gets me fucking uptight. And I want to say, you dumb fuck, you know what I'm saying? Like you dumb fuck. And then if a guy was dating her, I would want to say, you're even a dumber fuck. But that's what happens. What can I tell you? And I guarantee you, she probably posts on her fucking Facebook or Instagram shit, the blue screen, like the picture of the Eiffel Tower behind her and the fucking mouse ears and the dog nose and her and, you know, these superimposed.
You're talking about filters.
Whatever, yeah, filters. The filter should be a fucking bag over her face, which should be. Oh, let's move on.
I'm sure she has some nebbishy husband at home, though.
Oh, I guarantee
she's at her peasant call.
Guaranteed, she does not have a husband. I guarantee it. And there's
there are plenty of guys who go for that
and
kind of woman.
There's no woman that would have the fucking platinum vagina that would want to be with that retard. But let's move
on. Wait, what? There's no woman who would have a platinum vagina?
Outside now, making an
analogy. Oh, okay.
Not literally like on the back of the trophy for woman of the year is this platinum vagina.
Gotcha.
All right, but that's it. So that was, I had a great time. Beautiful outside. Great hang with mom. Great hang with her friends. Great lunch. But it's... That's my growth. I was proud of myself because I would want to say something.
I'm proud of you.
Yeah, I'm proud of myself too. I got to tell you, I'm very. Nice. I'm giving myself some credentials there.
Nice.
Or as you say, creds.
Right. And I missed lunch because I was sleeping until 2 p.m., which has never happened in my life.
You went to bed after 5. I know I got a text at 5:08, not coming home. So I know you were out. And then you came home in the same outfit.
I figured, I was like, man, I should probably. I was like, I should probably text that so he doesn't think I'm dead.
It would have been nice. I appreciate that.
So I did.
I put 5:08. And this episode, ladies and gentlemen, is about Bron and the man whore.
No,
I'm joking. No.
I can't stay out that late. How do you stay out
till 5 even?
It was extremely
difficult. I'm impressed.
It was extreme.
Why don't you tell the viewers what were you doing at 5 o'clock in the morning?
Well, I was out at a bar.
What time's the club end?
We left at like 3:30.
So they're open that late, huh?
Yeah, they're open till like 5.
That's it's unbelievable. Crazy. And people are there?
Oh my God.
It's truly unbelievable.
I think I left at 3 or 3:30. And but the place
I do appreciate you texting me to let me know. So when I did wake up at like 6:30, I saw it. And so I told mom last night, I go, mom, turn every light off. Bronson might not come home, or when he does.
And even if I come home, every time I come home, every Saturday night, the lights are all off. So it's fine.
Because I do it. Mom was... Right.
Mom texts me. She goes, I'm leaving the oven light on. And I was like, what?
No, but I said, you don't need a little, and she left your bedroom light on. Like, it's like,
what?
Like, it's like,
she's like, getting, she's no, like making,
almost, I think it makes her feel better herself. It's almost like the lighthouse and like Monta, like,
you're like
the
calling me, home. Like becking you, so beckoning me home.
And first of all, you know, the light over the cabana bath that stays until 1:30, whatever. Mm-hmm. There's enough light that comes in. You know,
I mean, I literally have my phone. And I just turn my flashlight on.
Or I can turn the light switch. On right. And turn off the other.
I do that every time I come home.
So I'm like, don't leave a light on. She goes, okay. But of course, what does she do? She has a light on. So I came down and said, let me just, when I put banks away, and your bedroom light was on and the oven light was on. And I got to tell you, if I came down this morning at 7 in the morning,
if my bedroom those fucking light was on,
I would have been fucking, first of all, those light bulbs like $8 a bulb.
The oven ones.
No, your other ones. Those are expensive.
She left those ones on? The one by my bedside?
Yeah, not
the overhead? That's so weird.
Isn't that weird?
Because those you have to go all the way around the bed.
And the door partially open, which means the fucking dog would have peed on the, Charlie.
Well, Charlie peed in front of Burke's room. It's all...
When? This morning?
I don't know. I saw it right when I was coming downstairs before we started this podcast. because it's
It's there now?
Yeah.
She didn't clean it?
And it's all caked in to the floor. Like it's all
that fucking dog. I will not miss him when he passes. All he does is
he's
shit.
He's very old. He's very old now.
Call a mom. Well, I wouldn't say
I hear her phone. She's right there.
Let's see if she answers. Where is she?
Well, I hear her phone in the kitchen.
I hear her, but she's usually right. She's, I mean, her phone is surgically implanted to her. Hey, Nell. Hey, so Bronson just told me we're on the podcast. Say hello to everybody.
Hi, everybody.
Okay, so Nelly, Bronson told me that Charlie peed again
in front of
Burke's room. It's all caked in.
Okay, so you're stopping your podcast to tell me that the dog peed in the house?
Are we doing a question with repeat the question?
I informed Dad, and then he goes, I have to tell Mom.
Right, so you wanted that dog. Can you clean your dogs? No,
we didn't stop. We're doing it right now. We're in it.
So listen to me. Stop your banter on the podcast. Okay. Are we gonna? I can do this all day. We're gonna do this. Can you clean the pee, please?
It's drying extra quick now.
It's drying. And can you clean the fucking dog?
No.
No, I'm dead serious. Can you? I'm asking you nicely.
No.
Do you see my listeners? This is what I live with. People think because she's pretty and smiles, she always says fucking no. Unless I gotta buy another Chanel, and no more Chanel. So you clean the pee. No, listen now. You know me, my OCD. I had the grout redone and all stained. Can you clean it, please?
Okay. Yeah, podcast.
It's going great.
It's good.
Thank you. I was telling how you left the lights on for Bronson and I knew he wasn't coming home, despite me telling you to turn them off. Well, and Bronson.
Listen.
Wait.
I'm a mommy, and I needed to have the light.
Mom, I'm 25.
Bronson, you know what's amazing technology? What you can do? You can turn the light switch on and turn it off when you get to the other end of the room because you have 3 switches.
Or I can just come into the house and walk right upstairs, even in the pitch black.
Yeah, because Bronson could use his feline evening vision. Okay?
Well, I just know the house. I walk in, I walk upstairs, and I go to bed.
So the point is now, because I want to get back to the podcast. Wait, now you're breaking up. We don't have a good cell. The only thing good is clean the urine in front of his room, please. Do I not do for you?
You do for me.
I appreciate it. Okay, now we'll do you. If you clean it.
Jesus.
Please clean it. It's caked in and I'm aggravated. All right?
Okay.
So we got another about 43 minutes. So by the time I come out, I want it cleaned.
Not 42?
No.
Oh, God. Thank you. Now you are the best. I don't care what they say about you. You're all right.
Okay.
All right? Bye.
Okay.
All right. So at least I got my grout cleaned.
Yes.
Fucking dog. The dog pees everywhere except the fucking grass. He takes a dump in the marble on the outside of our courtyard area. No, seriously.
It's not even real grass. I don't blame him.
No. Are you kidding me? It's fine. Should I get the grout and the marble outside the patio sealed or wait till the dog dies?
Wait till he dies.
I can't wait three more years. I might have to kill him.
Every day, every time I see Charlie, Charlie's our little dog who's the oldest one in the family. He's outlived three dogs. Literally, he was here first before three dogs, and he's still alive, and those three are dead.
Stupid fucking dog.
Hi, Mom.
Oh, she just walked in.
She walked at the show. Okay. No.
Oh, that's not good. It's filming. Mom, now
it's focused on us. So it's.
Yep. There she goes. If I can get you that shock collar and put her on your neck, that'd be great.
All right. Thanks, Mom.
Thanks, Nell. Squeaky door. Got to get the handyman to fix that.
Real. Wow.
Wow. Sounds like a horror house. Hello, my pretty. Go ahead. From Wizard of the Oz. You never heard that?
Wizard of the Oz.
Wizard of Oz.
And Wizard of Oz is a horror movie? That's a horror movie too?
When I was young, that shit
was
scary.
Those flying monkeys are scary
Very
as fuck.
Very scary. Thank you.
Those flying monkeys are scary as fuck.
I don't know what scary is. I don't know how fuck scary is, but yes, they were scary. So what is on? So that was my lunch. Great time. Fucking.
And I'm still It's
So what time do you so you went to bed?
It's 4 o'clock right now, and I've been up for 2 hours. My day started 2 hours ago. That's horrible.
What time did you go to bed?
5:30. But then I got up at like 9 because I can't sleep past 9 anymore. I just can't do it. So I'm up at 9, and then I went back to bed at 11 and then slept until 2.
Brother, watch this. Watch me piss my mom off, ready? Should I do it? Watch this.
She probably didn't even bring her phone upstairs.
I guarantee she's a woman. Watch. I hear it ringing. She might not have brought it up.
I don't think she did.
Because she didn't bring enough paper towel up I'm telling you, Sean, it was like 6 pieces of paper.
It was a big pee. Yeah, it covered like a whole square of Marvel.
She's going to smear it in.
All right. All right. All right. Let's get to it.
All right. Go ahead. I'm back.
But yeah, I can't. Basically, long story short, I can't.
We had a good time. So
I got to go to bed at midnight every night.
Be a little bitch. You had fun. And that's all that matters.
I had fun and I was hanging out with my friends and it was a good time and I don't regret anything. It's just, I'm like, oh my God, I'm so tired.
Okay.
I feel like I'm in college, but I'm not.
You're 25. Have a good time.
All right. So there's a lot. We got to talk about all this COVID stuff because there's a lot of news about COVID. God. I don't know if you know what COVID is. So there's a, that's a joke.
Oh, you're funny.
Oh, fuck. Wrong one. No, wrong one. That one.
No. That one. Yeah.
A lot of COVID news. So on which
I'm tired of.
The last bonus episode, so the Patreon episode that came out before, like the one before this, I wanted to get to all this news because it was pressing back then, but we talked for the whole hour. We talked about the Dante Wright case or the Dante Wright shooting, and we talked about George Floyd and Black Lives Matter. We devoted the whole hour to that, which was actually really interesting.
I'll never get that hour back.
I thought it was a good episode.
All that time on fucking hoodlums and BLM. I'll never get that.
They're not hoodlums.
Dwight?
Dante. Right?
Dante is a hoodlum. 1 minute, it's mom calling.
Why is he a hoodlum?
Hey, Nelly.
Did you really just call me again?
Yeah, I did, but I hung up. I just want to make sure. I don't think you had enough paper towel you brought up with you. It's a lot of pee.
He didn't even see it. He doesn't even know how much pee it. No, I didn't see that.
I saw the paper towel.
Oh, but you didn't see how much pee.
No, but Pierce Bronze told me it's a lot.
It was about a whole square of marble.
Yeah, and I know how much he pees.
Do you want to put your podcast on hold and go upstairs and look at it?
No, are you done?
Yeah.
Good job. I'm proud of you now. Proud of you. Bye. Bye. Bye.
Bye.
Jules, you called me while she called me back.
Well, because she saw Miss Paul John. So we didn't get to any of this COVID
news.
So
Dante
Wright
is a hoodlum.
Why?
He's a criminal. We had spoke about that last week.
So criminal and hoodlum are synonyms. So Bernie Madoff is a hoodlum?
Yeah, he's a bad guy.
So
continue.
Your friends, there are friends of yours, I'm not going to name names, who have been in jail. They're hoodlums.
Hoodlums, yes. Hoodlums, 100%.
See, because I think you use hoodlums as a racial thing. I think you wouldn't call a white guy hoodlum.
Hoodlum. Yes, I would.
No, you wouldn't.
Yes, I would.
I'm
telling you.
A white guy who goes to like white collar crime, who goes to like a nice prison, I don't think you would call them a hoodlum. I think you're
a low life.
I think you're. And this guy isn't. This guy never went to jail. Dante Wright was never in jail. He died before.
I don't want to spend another hour on this.
No, me neither.
Right,
me neither.
I'm 100% against what I don't 100% think that the way it was handled was wrong. Mm-hmm. I just don't think it was a racial thing. I think the fucking police are wrong. I think there's some negligence there. I don't know I don't think it was intentionally to harm persons because they're African American and black. I don't think it was racial. I 110% do not agree that that kid should be killed. Let me be very clear about that.
I agree with you
but
on both of those.
110% do not think it was a fucking racial thing.
I agree.
And it's the media and the news and the whole thing because it's what's in and sexy and stuff that are making a racial thing. Let's move on.
I 100% agree with you on all those statements. Okay, so a lot of COVID news, and I know you don't want to talk about it, but I think that this is really interesting stuff for many reasons. Scary stuff and, okay. So
you mean the bullshit stuff?
So first, I have like four of them. So
We're going to be quick then.
I know. Okay. So the first one, I'm sure you've heard it by now. And I'm sure all our listeners have heard by now because we're a little late to this story. But the Johnson & Johnson vaccine, which is one of the three vaccines that's being offered in America, has been halted. The CDC said, do not inject the Johnson & Johnson vaccine anymore.
I'm getting the fucking vaccine. It's the best thing. It's been tried on two people. Great trial. You know, whatever.
Well, over 6 million doses of the Johnson & Johnson vaccine have been administered in America, and 6 people experienced like really bad blood clotting inside their body. So it's over 1 in a million chance of it.
Very low chance.
Very, very low chance. And I appreciate that the CDC is trying to be extra careful. Like not that I trust them in what they've been saying because they've lied to us all year.
You know my thoughts on the vaccine. You know my thoughts on having to take it because I'm being told to take it. I have issues with that. But But on the same token, blood clots can come from many different ways. It could be how it's administered by the shot. It can be in someone's health condition.
It can be an underlying condition, right?
A pre-existing condition. It could be in what kind of additional...
Or it could just be a coincidence.
Other meds they have. So there's many, many, many things out there. I just think there's a lot of scrutiny because, again, it's COVID and it's one of the three that are out there and therefore there's a lot of scrutiny.
But I feel like for the government, for the U.S. government, they know how delicate these vaccines are in the public eye. Like they know that half of America doesn't want to take them.
Or?
I feel like this is... For them to do this, because you know that them doing this is going to tank confidence in the vaccine, which it has. Now everyone's like, see, there it is.
I don't know.
I feel like for them to do this, that means there was a serious fucking issue. They knew that something, because if it was less than one in a million.
Maybe what, Moderna and Pfizer, is that it? Mm-hmm. Maybe they paid more lobbyists and there's some more kickbacks to get rid of fucking to tank the, who knows? Pfizer. Bryce texts me, so I just got to see what the deal is.
I think that Pfizer... So like in the public eye, everyone views Pfizer as the elite one. And I've heard a lot of stories about Moderna, people getting sick from. Like most people, they say that if you're getting the Moderna one, like after the second shot, you're rocked for a while, like a couple days.
I've had friends that have taken, I don't know which shots, but they have got bad for 2 or 3 days.
Every person who I know who took the Moderna one specifically was very sick after. Every single person I know, for like 2 days, they were sick.
Right. Again, I don't know which one it was.
But then again, that could be public. Like, that could be, who knows? I'm not going to put it past any of these companies. That could easily be Pfizer paying
people
to have the news. Correct. So it's everyone wants Pfizer vaccine because that's the elite.
So you don't know with the, we don't know with Johnson & Johnson. I also think 1 out of 1 million is a very slow chance. I wouldn't want to be the 1 out of 1 million. I get it. But I would wait, period. I wouldn't take a fucking shot until... Two generations, like a generation from now. That's my opinion. Because I'm not opposed to vaccines. I take the flu shot. I'm opposed to being told I have to, like it's fucking neo-Nazis into control. And I'm also don't want to be the guinea pig from the beginning. I mean, for you know, I could become sterile. You don't know.
I did see another interesting thing. Well, no, actually, this isn't a good point. Because I was going to say, like people take experimental medicine all the time.
Their choice.
Yeah.
That's their choice. And if you're dying of cancer and there's no cure or whatever,
right,
or something like that, you'll do anything to fucking...
That's why I realized it was not a good point.
All right, so we knocked out that one issue.
Nice.
We have three more.
So speaking, you were like, I just don't want it to be like forced. I don't want it to be neo-Nazi, whatever you said.
That's exactly what I said.
Right. So going down that route. Last week, there on the island of St. Vincent, I talked to you about this off the podcast, but I figured let's talk about it on the podcast. So the island of St. Vincent is a Caribbean island in the Caribbean, obviously. And
an island in the middle of the water.
It's a volcanic island. And the volcano, like the government of the island knew that the volcano was erupting, right? Like the volcano was about to erupt. So they ordered evacuation of 16,000 people off the island. Because they were like, you're going to die. Like we're going to die if we don't get off this island. American cruise ships, so Royal Caribbean and Celebrity Cruise lines sent cruise ships down to the island so that everyone could get on and we can do like one big evacuation. Because how else are you going to evacuate?
I think that's very nice.
Very nice. It was great.
Did they do karaoke night?
And did they do the newlywed game?
Right, right.
And trivia?
Right.
So they evacuate.
I miss cruising, bro.
It's going to come back. Speaking of Florida senator, I think it was Marco Rubio, one of the Floridian senators proposed a bill to lift the travel ban on cruises and to be like, okay, it's time today we need to start the Florida cruise industry again because we haven't had it in a year and a half now. And that's a huge part of our state.
Yeah, it'll be fun. Yep.
Okay, so
go on.
St. Vincent, the government of St. Vincent ordered 16,000 people to evacuate. They had the ships waiting, ready. The government was like, here you go. We're evacuating you. The catch was you had to prove that you were vaccinated to be able to evacuate off the island. So in order in a life or death situation.
So what if you weren't vaccinated? You don't come off?
Like, you're stuck on the island.
Too late to get.
If you weren't vaccinated, you were.
Why don't they put the non-vaccinated people on one cruise? Ship?
Because it's not about actually that. It's not actually
it's
about
the control and power. Right.
It's to force people to get vaccinated.
You bring up a couple issues there. So first of all, again, you know my thoughts on the vaccine and getting it and not to get it now. I think Celebrity and Carnival, whatever, the cruise line.
It was Royal Caribbean and Celebrity.
Okay.
Let me just...
It doesn't matter. It doesn't change the story for our purposes.
Yeah. Royal
Caribbean. But my point, so they're allowed to, their privately held company. I mean, they're publicly held, but they're a private company. They're not governed by the government. I think they could say whether or not they want their people coming on their ship to be vaccinated or not. I think they're allowed to. You can make a choice as a guest whether or not you want to and patron on their ship or not. And if you don't get it, you don't go. I have no issue with that.
You know that's how it's going to be. You're not going to be able to go on a Royal Caribbean cruise out of Miami without a vaccination. Okay,
but I don't agree with the way the world's becoming, but I do agree with the fact that
the principle of
and then
the
because company. My choice whether or not I want to get it done, because it's a company, they have their choice. So I get that. Okay. Just like I don't think masks should be mandated. If a store owner says you gotta have a mask and they're just then it should be their choice. I don't agree with it, but it should not be a government choice.
It should definitely not be a government choice, but I agree in theory that a private business should be able to do what they want. However, that's a very tricky road because let's say, because you're like, then you just don't use that store, right? Like, let's say store A wants you to use masks and store B doesn't.
Right.
So you just go to store B.
Correct.
That's the capitalistic viewpoint of it.
Correct.
Right. However.
Just like no shirts, no service, right?
Right. But that becomes tricky because let's say, which is going to happen likely, that every airline, like all the airlines, which are private, are going to make you show like that you're vaccinated. I doubt there's going to be one or two airlines that are like, no, we don't care at all. They're all going to be it. So then you don't have store A or store B. You That's only have store A.
I agree. It's a problem.
And it's not like it's just a store. It's travel.
No, it's a
so
problem.
So you're not going to be able to travel anywhere on a plane.
It's a problem.
Without it. Like that's where it gets really tricky because society will change forever. It'll be like,
There's no doubt society's going to change, unfortunately. Just like after 9/11, just like after the fucking Capitol thing with steel fence around it. This, unfortunately, people drank the fucking Kool-Aid. It's a fucking joke. The stats are being fed to you are not even accurate or true. And it's going to change. It's changing. I have a hard time accepting it. Doesn't mean I have to accept it, but there's certain things I want to do in life. I'm going to have to deal with it.
Yeah.
I just have no choice. I can't fight everybody and sue everybody.
That's why we have to, that's why Florida has to just become its own country and then we can have our own rules.
Yeah, but you still have a problem traveling. I like going to Europe.
We just have to start our own airline.
Yeah.
Or the market might
start our own world.
Idealistically, the market will correct itself. So if there's enough people that say, no, I'm not getting vaccinated, one of the airlines will say, okay, we'll be the one that serves you guys.
Maybe.
To make that money.
That might happen. How great would that be?
We'll serve those customers. That's how the market usually corrects itself. Because if 30% of the world is now not going to be able to fly because they don't want to get vaccinated, some airline is going to say,
Are requiring.
Right.
And you
have, like Israel, you're not going to be able to go. You're not going to be able to go to Israel without
no jurisdiction.
Passport.
There's no jurisdiction we have. So if you want to go, and you got to carry it. What's it, a stamp on your passport? You've been vaccinated?
No, it's like, have you seen those CDC cards? Everyone is like posting.
So you
got to
walk on another card.
A card. It's like a social security card. So but
I got
CDC.
Get a fake one made.
They're already saying.
Do they scan it?
No. Some of them have barcodes on them, but most it's just written out. Like it's just written, you got it on this date at this location.
What are they already saying?
It was the CDC or the FDA. I think it was the FDA was saying that they're already issuing like $750 fines and like potential jail time for people who are faking cards because people are already faking.
I'll worry about it then. Like every kid, you know, in high school had a fake ID going out.
But now it's very hard to get it gets harder and harder with technology and they're doing it digitally. That's another thing. They're already starting. So New York State has a digital one.
New York State.
So it's on your phone and it's a code that's scanned. So you can't fake that because it's not paper. So that's how it's going to become.
But the Florida one's paper?
Well, the CDC one is paper. Florida, DeSantis said, we will not have any form of vaccine passport whatsoever in this state at all. We will not require it for any government facilities. We will not force any businesses to require it. You will not have to use any vaccine passport. Meanwhile, New York has already established
New
it.
New York, fuck
to get
moron.
Into certain stores, to get into certain venues, to Could get into certain buildings, ID? You have to have your phone scanned to ensure, and then they have your medical history and your medical records.
Medical history on that. So they have all your information.
So Bank of America, to get into Bank of America, I have to give them my medical records.
And you know they sell that information.
Of course they do.
Yeah.
Of course
it's they the do. World.
Because, you know,
all purposely
because
done.
The private tech companies are the ones that develop the apps and the software for the government
Correct.
To use. So then they store that in
it's
a database
data
somewhere.
Mine. It's called data
right.
mine.
And we know that those companies sell our data anyways. We know that Facebook and Twitter and Google, they
just
sell
by
our
the
data
ads.
All
just
the time.
Just by the ads that come up, yep.
And, I mean, there was the huge breaches.
This is more reason for these foreign countries that hate America to learn out more about the fucking people, consumers, so they can destroy our country. This is warfare.
Right. Or who knows? Like Facebook, we know that they have a lot of ties with China and the Chinese Communist Party. They could easily be like Facebook can be developing their own app that gets now used. And let's say all of California uses the Facebook vaccine passport. And then Facebook, meanwhile, on the side, is just slipping all that medical information to China.
Correct.
To
and no one
to use for God
no
knows
one
what.
Other my doc needs my medical information.
Right.
That's no,
like
I
what Bill Burr or not Bill Burr, Bill Maher this week, he said he was like, I want politics out of my medical decisions.
I want
he was
politics
like,
out of
my medical
everything.
Decision should only be with me and my doctor.
Right. Fuck them all.
Yeah.
I agree.
But that's a scary one with the government.
Very scary.
The government of a country is saying we're all going to die. However, the only ones that can get saved are the ones who are vaccinated.
So the ones who said, oh my God, my vaccine's in a week from now, too late.
I guess.
Nice.
Yeah. You got to seek your own shelter. Your government has failed you. The government is saying, which is going to happen everywhere. This is just a precursor to what's going to happen everywhere if we allow it. The government's saying, we'll do our duty. We'll help our citizens. We'll help the people that we were put in power
with
to
with
help.
With a caveat.
Right, exactly. If you do this,
yeah,
that we want you to. Yeah, that one's scary. Okay, so this next one is...
Two down, two to go.
This next one might be the craziest one because I think you're going to flip about this. So what was one of the main... What was one of the main worries but from a lot of people?
Ooh, oh,
you almost just pulled the power out of our board.
But I did not,
no,
right?
No.
Okay, good.
And I locked it in this time.
Good. Proud of you, buddy.
What was one of the main reasons that you heard from people being worried about the vaccine? Like, people were saying, like, I don't want the vaccine because...
A woman saying it? Or
no,
people?
No. People were like, I don't want the vaccine
because... I don't want the government. It's like they're planting something in you and the government keep track of you and everything
right.
else.
So a lot of people were saying... Who knows? There could Bill
right.
Gates is going to put microchips in it,
right?
Right.
Who the fuck knows?
Okay, you ready for this?
Do I really want to know?
Let me connect to the sound. Because it's a video.
People are fucking dumb. They're so fucking dumb. I'm telling you, they don't...
Here, this video.
Dr. Hepburn showed us...
Okay, hold on. This is from 60 Minutes. This was published April 11th. So this is a 60 minutes report.
Current projects. Some sound like they're from an episode of Star Trek. Consider a ship like the USS Theodore Roosevelt, hobbled last year when 1,271 crew members tested positive for the coronavirus. What if everyone on board had their health monitored with this subdermal implant, now in late stage testing? It's not some dreaded government microchip to track your every move, but a tissue-like gel engineered to continuously
Bullshit.
Test your blood.
It's a sensor.
This tiny green thing in there?
That tiny green thing in there, you put it underneath your skin, and what that tells you is that there are chemical reactions going on inside the body, and that signal means you're going to have symptoms tomorow.
Wow.
Okay.
There's an actual transmitter in that?
Yeah, it's like a check engine light.
Check this sailor out before he infects other people.
That's right.
Who's going to go into the army?
Okay, wait. So that's the
no
Pentagon.
No one's going to go into military.
Dad. This article, this is from CBS News, which is 60 Minutes. The Pentagon projects that helped combat COVID-19 and may help end pandemics forever. So the Pentagon has been working on this. DARPA is the one who's behind it. Yeah, it says right here. So DARPA, this is one of the directors of DARPA, which I don't know if you know anything about DARPA.
Nope.
But that's the secret research arm of the U.S. military. They're responsible for a lot of conspiracy theories.
A lot of shit going on.
That people that have become true. When people are like, that's a conspiracy theory, and now it's just truth, we know. DARPA was one of the people who did it. Remember we talked about HARP?
Yeah.
And how HARP can control the weather? DARPA was the arm of the military that developed HARP. DARPA, they're doing it as the Pentagon, but DARPA is the, I believe it's Defense and Research. Hold on, let's see what DARPA stands for. Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency. And they develop, like, where was that article? So DARPA, under the Pentagon, has already developed a microchip
with a transmitter. All military, so they can keep track where you are. They get...
I mean, it's in theory, that's a nice idea. Something that goes inside your body that will tell you
It's LoJack.
What's that?
Means the transmitter can find out where you are. LoJack is the thing you put in cars. So if your car gets stolen, you can always track your car.
But like in theory, it's a nice idea. Something in my body will tell me that I'm going to be sick before I'm sick.
Do you really want to know?
But like in theory, that's a good idea, especially for a soldier. Like you can make sure that your soldiers are all top.
I get it.
However, that's such a slippery slope that they're already in the news. They're like, this is a great thing. We're going to put a transmitter inside your body. And you can already see the headlines in 5 years from now.
Correct. They've already been there. They've already been there.
Right. But like in 5 years from now, you can already see the headlines. The COVID-19 chip that you put in now has a software update. Now it has the capability to...
Right. We can
program... To shut your body down tomorrow. To
program you what we want you to do.
Right. And like
the movies.
If you're being a dissident, right? Like let's say you're rioting. Boop. We press a button. Right. You're just powered down.
Right. They could shut something that could cause a wavelength to your heart or something.
Yeah. Or they can... control your muscles.
It's like the movies from years ago. Yeah, fuck that. I don't want anything in my body.
And this was on 60 Minutes.
You know how many people do it? Because people are fucking dumb. Because all the hair is, you'll be able to make me better before I even get sick. I want it.
Well, and if the CDC says
endorse
people
it.
Should do this, a lot of people will be like, yes.
Fucking
a lot of people will be like, okay, put it in.
Let them do it. I will, not me. Wow.
I know, but then that's another slippery slope. Because... as this stuff starts to happen, like biotech and the Neuralink and all that stuff,
I hope I'm dead before these things come out.
That's going to be the biggest change to society, because it's going to be the people who have it and the people who don't have it. And the people who have it, it's going to get more and more like godly, right? Like think, if you have that chip, you'll never get sick because it'll tell you that you're sick before and then you can prevent it. And then you'll have a Neuralink, so your brain's connected to the internet, and so you'll be like a super soldier. You'll be a fucking Captain America.
No, you won't. You'll
and
see, then we you'll won't be surprised. Be. People thought with fucking social media and the cell phones was the greatest thing in the world. It's fucking destroys.
Well, there are pros and cons, but think about how more connected the world is now because of the cell phones, for better or worse. So for better or worse, biotech
I still think old school is the fucking way to go. I don't agree with that. I don't want any fucking thing in my body. Hell fucking no.
But the problem is it's inevitable. This stuff is coming and it's going
maybe
to happen.
Hopefully not in my lifetime.
It's here. Speaking of Neuralink, there was a Neuralink story this week.
Wait, you're out of order. We got one more topic left.
They had, this is a clip of a monkey who has a Neuralink chip in his brain.
That's a real monkey?
And it's playing Pong with its brain. It's doing that. It's controlling that computer with its brain.
No way.
It's controlling both of those things. It's playing a full game of Pong. In its
head.
That
is amazing.
It's just thinking of what it wants it to do.
Okay, so wait. So a couple things. First of all, that's a real monkey?
Yeah. Here's a video.
Wow.
This is Pager. He's a 9-year-old macaque who had a Neuralink placed in each side of his brain about 6 weeks ago. If you look carefully, you can see that the fur on his head hasn't quite fully grown back yet. He's learned to interact with a computer for a tasty banana smoothie delivered through a
straw. Look how he's controlling a cursor.
We can interact with the Neuralinks simply by pairing them to an iPhone. Just as you might pair your phone to a Bluetooth speaker.
This is scary shit. His brain's connected to that iPhone.
The links record from more than 2,000 electrodes implanted.
Woman, this is scary, woman.
Motor cortex that coordinate hand and arm movements. Neurons in this region modulate their activity with intended hand movement. For example,
Musk tweeted last week, he said, The first Neuralink product will enable someone with paralysis to use a smartphone with their mind faster than someone using their thumbs. Which, that's amazing.
Those are good things.
That's amazing, it's also terrifying.
A lot of bad things, I think. A lot of bad things.
It's terrifying. And then also, what Elon's goal with it is, his whole thing is that he says, we're going backwards in terms of our interfacing with technology. Like, it used to be all our fingers, right? It used to be all 10 fingers you used to interface. Now it's just mainly our thumbs. And he's like, that's bad. Our thumbs are not good. They're not quick. They're not versatile. So he's like, why can't we just use our brains to interface with it?
Is it okay? This guy's brilliant.
Yeah. And the fact that they're doing it, like, it's working.
No, it's crazy. That guy's fucking brilliant.
But then the next step that they want to do, so this is the first step that, step is they want to just have it where you can connect to your phone or the computer and just do everything just by thinking what you want to do. But then the next step.
So you Google in your computer, you search just by thinking.
Well, you just Google. I'll just search Google for Neuralink and it'll just come up. And then I'll be like, okay, scroll down. Okay. Like, you just will think.
I don't like that. That's bad. And scary.
What we do right now is we think it. And then we send the signal to our hand, and then our hand does it. And instead, we'll just think it, and it'll do it.
Okay, but you do know if you go, this is the part's the problem. You sync it to your iPhone, or you sync it to your computer, whatever it is. That computer
iPhone has the ability,
and so we're going to put ads in your fucking brain that you subconsciously, subliminal thinking. You're not going to, you say, you know what, hon? I want Italian tonight. Is that free will?
Right. I want Carrabba's.
Wait. Is that free Olive will? Garden. Right. Or is that? Am I going to Olive Garden? I'm in the mood for Olive
Garden. Because Olive Garden pays.
I think for Olive Garden. I think dinner's cheap, $9.95. I can get all you can eat pasta.
Right.
Is that me? No. Fuck this. I will not do that, Bronson. I'm not doing it.
You pay extra a month, like Hulu. You pay for no ads. You get the base one for ads.
You do know that's what's going to happen. They're going to be able to put shit back in, and you will never know if it's you free will thinking or not. And then here's the other problem. Just like you said with that chip they can put in there, they can shut you fucking down.
And also, it'll be able to connect to your visual cortex. That's like what their plan is. So that it'll be able to connect to what you see.
So they can see what I'm seeing.
Well, so they could potentially see what you're seeing. But then also, they can implant things into your vision. So you'll never, theoretically, you might never know what real reality looks like.
So you can have virtual reality without even putting a machine on.
Yes, that's part of the plan.
What they want.
That's part of the plan. But then also what's scary is that, like, you could be let's say down the road you have to pay, right? Let's say the Neuralink, you have to pay to get it placed in, and you're like in a subscription or whatever, right? So you have to pay to like keep it operating. This is what I'm saying, how it'll stratify the haves and have nots, because the people who can afford to get all this stuff will be like gods, and the people who can't afford it will be like ants.
Okay, well, I can afford it, I'm not doing it.
But the thing is, let's say it's on a subscription base, right? So you pay monthly fee to keep the Neuralink active. Let's say you don't pay 1 month. They might just shut off your visual field.
Who knows?
Until you pay, it'll just say...
Right, how do you get it out?
In your vision, it'll just say...
You owe $29.99. Right. How do you get it out? How would you get that Neuralink out?
You'll have to have surgery to get it out, just like
could
it was
you
placed
imagine
in
your fucking brain.
But then what they want to eventually do, Elon's plan for it ultimately, is to have it instead of...
Brain
to phone, it will be brain to brain. So then, like, we're doing a podcast right now and we're talking to each other. We have to think about what we want to say. We have to articulate it, talk it out, and then you have to interpret what I'm saying, and it's never fully correct. With Neuralink, what their plan is that you would just know my thoughts. So I don't have to articulate it. You just know.
You know how bad that is for life, period?
Well, there won't be privacy anymore. Imagine if you just know my thoughts. And everyone will be a mind reader. That's really dangerous.
Fucking people don't know what they're getting into. So our podcast.
That's
just
what Elon wants to do.
This is our podcast. We just like this. Don't talk. Just look at me. That's what our podcast is.
But it wouldn't even be that. It'll be, people will just connect directly to our brains to hear our thoughts on something.
Oh, yeah, I'm letting that happen. They can have my ATM number, my alarm code, the safe code and everything. Give me a fucking break.
No, I know, right? Isn't that terrifying?
Fucking, okay. People
and then people will hack into it. People can hack into it.
Of course.
And then people can hack into any tech.
Wire me money. Right. Think about it.
Or not even wire me money. Just get into your brain.
No, I'm getting your brain, right, and telling you I'm going to force you to wire me money.
Or you don't even have to. You just get into my brain. You learn all of my bank account codes and you just walk into the bank and withdraw all my money.
But that's fraud. You could say this person's wiring me money if you want.
True. Oh, that's true.
They didn't know
which happens nowadays anyways.
Right, the elderly get screwed with social. Yes, exactly. Someone calls up saying, "This is a Social Security disability department." That's sad. You're evil. When you prey on people like that, you're fucking evil.
Yeah, especially old people.
Those people should die.
Yes, I agree. Those people should be hunted down and put in jail. Okay,
remember what happened with you and Anna, my mom?
Yeah,
she called me and says, "I got a phone call. Is Bronson arrested?" I just got a phone call saying Bronson arrested, and for $5,000 we can get him off for bail. And I said, "No, mom, ignore it. Ignore that call." Horrible. Those fucking people.
You
should
don't
die.
Think Bubby would fall for any? So
I had a client of mine that literally fucking called up. He elderly guy, successful guy, really nice guy. They made it sound like a Social Security department. He gave him a Social Security number, and now he had to fucking go through all this fraud, identity theft, everything. Get a new Social. Could you imagine? Those are evil fucking people.
Yeah.
To get back to, first of all, Elon Musk is brilliant. Number one, because he
might be too brilliant. Like, that's too.
Because what's amazing about Elon Musk is, okay, and people think about these things, but implementing is a different story. This guy can fucking implement anything.
He's done it. Every idea he's had, he's proven to be able to work.
Which is true.
To not only work, but be successful at it. Tesla is the most successful car company in terms of their stock in history. SpaceX has taken all the contracts from the government. Like, there's all of his companies are successful.
The one with the tunnel underground.
The Boring Company.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
It's brilliant to implement it.
Yep.
Wow. I think people are fucking morons if they do allow this to happen. That's my opinion. And there are people that will do it. You know that.
I do. I definitely, though, would rather have it from a private company than a government implanted chip. Neuralink private funded.
Either way is a major problem.
It's a problem. But don't you see like how that'll be? I read a whole book on this a while ago. It's called Homo Deus. I highly recommend it to anyone. Basically talking about the future of humanity and like where we're going to go and how we're going to have nanobots in our body that will kill any disease so that we'll be immortal.
Which and they is say, not good either.
They say that'll likely be within the next 50 years that humans will be able to be like a human born now will likely live forever. Most scientists agree on that. Mistake. That there's a human alive today that will probably be able have the ability to live forever.
Not good.
Because think about it. All dying is your cells getting old and dying, or illness.
It's breakdown.
So if you can have little robots swimming throughout your body that are constantly repairing everything, you can you'll be able to last forever. Your body will last forever. Or you can just replace parts. Oh,
like
liver. I'll just get a new liver. Boom.
Like a car.
Right. Or like a house, you put a renovation on a house and you redo it.
I get it. Bad.
But then the thing is, those things cost money. So then the problem with that's what this book talked about.
Okay, the movie with Justin Timberlake.
In Time.
That's like this.
Right. Or like Gattaca is a perfect example of like of this. Because you're going to have the people who can afford it are going to live like gods and be able to do what they want. And then they're going to be the people who can't afford it, who will basically just die off. And then we'll live in a society of just ultra wealthy gods without any working class, without any workers, and society will crumble. It will fall.
It's terrible.
If everyone lives forever, then there's no reason to have children and replicate.
I want to live forever.
But think about it. If you're immortal, babies will stop being born.
No, Brian,
so then families will break down.
Brian, it's a bad thing. People don't think about it. They just think about immediate gratification. They don't think about the consequences of the future, and I think it's a bad thing.
It's bad.
Bad. Very bad.
Yeah, I think we have to I think we have to start going back.
Ronnie, I've always been old school. Always.
Yeah,
We have to go back to certain old-fashioned, old-school values.
Not even old. We just have to start like regressing to what we were evolved to do.
Digressing? Like, digressing.
Or
digressing.
Digressing is like
going backwards.
No, digressing is going to the side, I think.
No,
like
No, digressing.
I thought like regret.
No.
Yeah, you might be right, actually.
I am right.
No, see, digress is leave the main subject temporarily. It's like go on a tangent is digressing. Regress.
Oh, I'm wrong.
Regress is to return to a former or less developed state.
Wow, look at you. I am impressed, Bronny. Well done. Well done.
We have to regress a bit.
Oh, yeah,
as humans.
Me digress for a moment. You go
right. Digress is like a tangent.
Yeah, go ahead.
I think through COVID, we've realized, or at least I've realized.
I'm impressed, Bronny.
I've realized that was all that money that you paid for my education.
You're an avid reader. That's what it's for.
I think through COVID, I've learned that you have to just focus on, not like, don't focus on tech, don't focus on screens,
focus
don't
on family memories.
Focus on like things that you enjoy doing in person and small scale. Like I remember, I 2 years ago, I thought about like, how much can I accomplish macro level? Like, you know, I want to make movies that everyone sees my name, or I want to do it.
Nothing wrong with that.
But like, I want to do it on a big scale. I want to live in a big city where I have as like a big influence, and I want to do all this. And I've learned that it's like, that's the opposite of what we should all want. Everyone should focus on your family and your small community and work there and have the influence there and like the community. Yeah, and then if everyone does that well, then society as a whole will be fixed. If everyone focuses on the micro instead of the macro. I think that's my opinion.
Okay.
I focus on your village, you know, like go back to the mindset of a 1200 human.
I know, but things are different today though.
Right, but basically I'm saying we need to become less connected as a world.
I hate the fucking social media.
Just focus on your own little community.
I hate the cell phones. I hate all that shit.
Yeah, I know you do.
Hate it.
Okay, lastly, I do want to talk about this because this was also big news. So speaking of the Pentagon, this is from Fox News. So let's just watch this video. It's easier for this video to do it than me explain it.
Meantime, UFO sightings in New York have nearly doubled since the pandemic began, and we are getting new video from the Navy showing pyramid-shaped objects flying in the sky.
Do you see those?
Yeah.
Oh, wait, so he said, video confirmed by the Navy, right? So this video is confirmed by the Navy. It was filmed by Jeremy Corbell, who's an investigative journalist. He was on Joe Rogan a few times talking about aliens. Mm-hmm. He shot this footage over a naval battleship 2 years ago, and the Navy last week confirmed that the footage is real and that they do not know what it is, and that it is part of an ongoing investigation and report.
Is live for us in Brooklyn, New York. Brian, good morning.
Trace, good morning. This extraordinary video and images of unidentified flying objects, or UFOs, were leaked to investigative reporter Jeremy Corbell and investigative reporter George Knapp. This night vision video purportedly shows three pyramid-shaped UFOs flying over the USS Russell, the coast of California in July of 2019. Oh, yeah. At one point, these UFOs reportedly hovered just 700 feet above the tail of the Navy destroyer, making, quote, extraordinary
that
maneuvers.
That gives me chills.
Now, says the unclassified video is part of a classified government report intended to educate officials about unidentified crafts flying over restricted airspace.
That's real.
These cell phone photos taken by a FA-18 pilot in March of 2019 show three different unidentified aircrafts off the coast of Oceania, including two UFOs dubbed the Metallic Blimp and another called the Sphere. A Department of Defense spokesperson said, quote, I can confirm that the referenced photos and videos were taken by Navy personnel. The Unidentified Aerial Phenomena Task Force has included these incidents in their ongoing examinations. However, the Pentagon was unwilling to confirm these three photos, which Corbell says came from the USS Omaha, showing a UFO diving into the ocean and disappearing.
Did you see that? These pyramids
off the coast of California.
For those who are listening, the video that they're talking about that the Navy confirmed is real. It's these pyramids.
The Navy has a whole department on this thing.
Yes. And remember the COVID bill that passed at the top of this year. Remember, we talked about this. There was a line in it that was buried deep, deep in the bill that said by June 20th or June 19th of 2021, the Pentagon has to release their findings on UFOs. That's less than 2 months away. We're going to get the report. Remember, my theory was that they're slowly trickling out this information so that when they reveal it, it's not as big of a shock. So that come June 20th, the government comes and
shock,
says,
by the way,
June 20th, when the government comes out and says aliens are real, we've interacted with them.
You don't think that's a big shock?
It certainly is. But why the last 2 years have the since we've started this podcast,
a couple have come up.
The government of the United States have confirmed multiple sightings of UFOs. That's never happened before. Usually it's always hush hush. And now they're like, okay.
Wow. It'll be interesting.
This video,
like, is this Transformers the movie?
Shaped UFOs flying over the USS.
That is, that gives me chills looking at that. It's a pyramid. For those who are listening, well, I'll try to describe it the best I can, but you should really watch it. It's a pyramid, three-dimensional, right? Like, it's not a triangle, it's a pyramid. So it's on multiple sides. It looks large. There's three of them, and it's fully metallic. You can see it reflecting. The
reflection, yeah.
And it's hovering in the sky.
Wow.
Imagine. I'm so pumped for aliens to
really?
For the government to reveal.
It doesn't scare you a little bit?
Well, it does. You know why it doesn't scare me? Because, one, it's out of my control. So there's no point
of
being scared.
You can still be scared out of your control.
But also, Dad, if...
Wait, you've never been scared when things out of your control?
Yes, but like...
You're not going to stress over something like this.
Right, but also, why would I... If aliens have... Right, let's say the U.S. government in June comes out and says, yes, we have had contact with aliens, whatever, or at least...
Jesus, that would be fucking crazy, Bronny.
But then why would you be afraid? I wouldn't be afraid of it because that means they've been here for so long and we're here right now. We're alive. We're doing shit. They haven't killed us yet. So why would I be afraid of them? It's not like they're just going to come and kill us when
maybe,
they were announced.
Maybe they walk among us. Do you ever see that movie with the sunglasses?
No,
there's a movie where all the aliens, they were transmitting through this, like... this radio tower, and one guy's like, I'm telling you, the aliens, they look like us, but the special sunglasses, if you wear the sunglasses, you could see the real alien's face.
Oh, I don't know that movie. There's a lot of things but with that premise, though. I don't know it.
Yeah, it's, I wonder if you type in, like, alien.
I'm sure I could find it.
It's an interesting movie, and no one would believe him. Like, alien sunglasses walking on Earth or something. I don't know. The future.
They live. John Carpenter's They Live.
Let me
live.
See the guy. Yeah, 100%. Yes.
Oh, this looks cool. That I gotta watch good, this.
Ron. I'll watch it again with you.
Yeah, let's watch this.
Yeah, I watched it. I've seen it like twice.
Oh, that's cool looking.
Yeah, and but they walk among us, and then it's these sunglasses that
show you. Who knows?
They
easily could be here right now.
You know what, Bronny? If you told me Pelosi and Harris was running this country and Biden was our president, I'd be like, no. I go, I believe in aliens before that, so yeah I believe in aliens.
That video gives me chills. Like, I have goosebumps looking
at
that stuff.
But the fact that it's so matter of fact, and I think the one with the fucking guy, the Air Force guy flying with his plane and from his cell phone.
Look at that picture.
But
that
you
is
know
not,
how high he is? He's in an F-18, Bronson.
That is not a ship that looks like anything that humans have made.
No.
It's like an orb, and it has
and
multiple pieces.
And more importantly, you know how high he is and how fast he's going in fucking F-18?
And Navy pilots are some of the most trained visually people in the world, right? Like they're
because they have to land on that ship.
Well, no, but I mean, like, to be a pilot, you have to be what am I trying to say? Like, I trust the pilot's vision and what they think they see more than most people. That's what a military pilot's trained for.
I get it.
And so if they're seeing things and they're like, that is not something I've ever seen before. I do not know what I'm looking at.
Wow, I mean, this
and
to
the
me
fact
is
that the Pentagon photos and the statement from the Pentagon said we can confirm that the reference photos and videos were taken by Navy personnel and the Unidentified Aerial Phenomena Task Force has included these in their ongoing examinations. So they say yes, this is a real picture.
We're researching,
and we have been researching it. We're constantly researching this stuff.
Scary.
I can't wait for that date to come. That the Pentagon has to release their findings to Congress. Who knows? I'm sure they're going to release a quarter
and
of the actual findings.
And why do they have to? Why is this a bill that came down?
Because Congress said it's Congress put it in the thing. They said, all right, it's time for the military to share their findings with us. We know that they've been examining this stuff, researching it. We want to know. They said the American people, it's time for them to know. I'm sure that we'll get a sliver of the actual information that actually exists because
the
government never
can. And they don't want to create hysteria anyway.
Right. But that's what I'm saying. That's my theory why they release videos like this is because this is slowly.
It's a massage.
Exactly. Crazy.
You've been right so far.
It would be so cool if next month we lived in a world where we knew aliens existed. I would love that. I would love that more than anything.
I would not. But I get it. I don't like it.
Why?
I don't see a need for it.
What do you mean?
I think it's a little scary, is my feeling.
The idea that to
who
know
knows
that there
knows
are
the technology and the power.
But that's I would be in awe. If they're even way more powerful than us, I would be like, that would be even more of a reason why I'd want to. I would want to meet aliens that are so much more advanced from us, so we can learn from them rather than aliens that are like ants
it
to us.
It happens like War of the Worlds. That's what happens.
But then why wouldn't it have happened already? If they're waiting. But also, if they're so advanced, why would they just obliterate shit? If they're so advanced, they wouldn't need to use violence at all. Someone so advanced in science and technology, they would just be able to harness energy wherever. Or that's the idealistic viewpoint. The other viewpoint is that if they're so advanced, they don't even, like, we're, to insects, we're so advanced, humans, and we view them as nothing. Like, you'll step on an anthill and you'll do nothing because they're ants. They're so insignificant to us. So a lot of people think that we're the ants to aliens. And so
who knows?
If our planet is in the middle of the way where they want to build their intergalactic highway, it's just like us clearing away an anthill with a broom because it's on our driveway. So they might just clear away our planet because we're right in the
way.
Who
knows?
Or another theory, which a lot of people say could exist, and that's why we haven't seen aliens, is that we're not even capable of comprehending what they would be. So a lot of people say, like, there could be a giant intergalactic mega highway right outside of Earth that we, like, right there, but we just don't even know what it looks like because we can't comprehend it. Just like a bumblebee doesn't know what I-95 is. It's right next to them, but they have no comprehension of what I-95 even is. Scary. So it doesn't exist to them. It's
an interesting concept. Either way, all of them are interesting concepts.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. Wow. I would love it. I would love to live in a world with aliens.
Well, there's a lot of fucking freakazoids out there. So you can, you know, we live in a fucked up world to begin with. So I don't know if I want to add in that whole other element to it.
I think that would help. I think that would unite people. As one, we're humans.
I think it would make the crazy Americans crazier.
Yeah.
That's my feeling.
Yeah. Also, we do live in a country full of aliens anyways. Illegal aliens. Got them.
That's so true. That's so true. We let them. Maybe we can give these aliens that from the Pentagon $86 million worth of hotel rooms.
Yeah.
Fucking morons. Maybe Pelosi's an alien.
A lot. I mean, people think that Hillary Clinton is like a lizard person.
Hillary Clinton is the daughter of the devil. Is a difference. It's a big difference. She's pure evil. She's evil.
Or maybe she's just an alien and we can't comprehend her ways.
No, she's evil. That's the way aliens are. You don't want aliens around. She's bad.
All right. We'll end on that note. Hillary Clinton is the Antichrist.
No. Is that the...
You said the daughter of the devil.
Is that the Antichrist is?
Well, the son of the devil is the Antichrist, yeah.
Okay. Well, she's like a dude anyway.
Right.
She'd totally be...
She wears suits.
She would be... She wouldn't be a lesbian because those are good looking. She's the dyke. Like the butchy one. Isn't that horrible?
That's horrible of you to say that.
Did I just say that loud?
Yeah.
I'm sorry. That's my Tourette's. I apologize, guys.
Some of your favorite people are butchy lesbians.
I don't care. Honestly,
I feel like you and butchy lesbians actually connect well.
Actually, I'm just teasing. That was for a little shock. Because I don't care if somebody's a lesbian.
No, of
that,
course
that
you don't.
Does not bother me at all.
But don't you agree? I feel like you bonded with butchy lesbians before.
And that was really wrong of me because I have nothing against someone's sexuality. So, and I hate Hillary. So that was a bad statement.
Right. Like, why bring lesbians down to the level of Hillary? You know, you like lesbians.
Yeah, I did it just because...
I know.
I make an analogy. You talk to guys, it's usually lesbians, and they're both
lesbians.
Gay.
Lesbians. Yeah, you always say that word so weird.
It's my... Listen, so it's a woman that's gay, right? And I'm just making general stupid statements. A lesbian, right? Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
And a dyke. They're both gay. But yeah. I'm just saying as a guy, when you like tease, like, you know how you guys picture girls at camp when they're younger, pillow right. fights and whatever in the bunk
or
beds.
Or like... They share a little kiss in the right. in the locker room, like right. in the showers.
Correct. Right, right.
Which so, never happens, no, ever.
It's just the way it is. So you especially like good-looking girls to be that are gay are lesbians. Uh-huh. And then you take the butchy ones with the jeans,
short
and the
hair.
Boots, short hair, and the little red hanky in the back pocket, you know, the Bruce Springsteen.
I love butchy lesbians.
But,
I think they're so fun.
But you understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
I don't care what someone is. But I was making the analogy because she's so nasty looking, Hillary.
I feel like I'd rather hang out in a group of butchy lesbians than feminine lesbians. Butchy lesbians are fun. Have you ever like?
No, I don't know.
I feel like they're a good group. They're a good crowd.
All right.
Because they're just dudes. I guess that's why they're a good crowd.
I guess, yeah.
Because they're just like one of the guys.
And I don't care. Who gives a shit? I don't care if someone's gay or not. It doesn't make a difference.
Yeah. All right, guys.
All right, Bronny, always good. Love you, brother.
Love you too.
Bronchler's coming up soon, right? A little quick little recap.
Bronchler's coming out soon. We're filming it next week, the first
Bronchler's episode. Coming out soon. We close it out for everybody. The committee closed it out, so we had about 130 apps. And now we have 30, I believe, we're keeping it to. And we have some new merch coming out in end of May.
End of May, we have really exciting stuff coming.
I'm not an idiot. So we have that coming out.
Exciting stuff.
We have
down the pipeline.
We have had amazing so far. A lot of people buying existing shirts. We have a couple left on the t-shirts.
We're pretty much down to just a women's shirts, which is awesome.
Right. And then we also have had a lot of new Patreon listeners. It's been great.
Yeah. Great honestly, following. everyone who's so we're at an hour 10. If you're listening to the podcast all the way through, which everyone should be, but I know when I listen to podcasts, a lot of times I'll stop 75% of the way because I do something and I never come back. So we're at the end of this episode. If you're listening, this is episode 25. If you're listening to episode 25 and you're at an hour and 10 minutes with us and you're not a Patreon member,
get the fuck out, bitch.
I mean, like, what are you doing? You devoted an hour and 10 minutes of your life to this. Wouldn't you want another hour each week?
And don't you want Bronson not to go back to LA? This helps him not come back to LA.
That's honestly the real, as far as the Patreon goes, we're about halfway to getting me to stay here.
We'll go live. We're going live. We'll go live this week as well.
Yeah.
All right, guys. Thank you very much for everything. Thank you for the continued loyalty, following us, listening, all the great support, all the great fucking comments, Bron. I mean, beyond belief. It's you guys that get me through the fucking retarded people like that girl with the dog when I was having lunch today. So love you guys. Bronny, love you.
Love you too, Dad.
Let's go take the convertible out now. Enjoy the end of the day, son.
Yes.
Later.
You're joking, right?
Well, yeah. I'm trying to be hopeful. I'm trying to be optimistic about that.
Well, I guess you're too young to be a little pessimistic like me. The fucking things I see out there, people are stupid.